Never see you again. magnificent to Venice on a horse. As a Castilian Hidalgo of that description, I would have preferred to ride through the streets of Venice. But owing to what I can only assume is an unusually wet season, the streets are in such a condition that equestrian exercise would be impractical. No matter.
Where is our seat?
Your Grace, I am here.
And why do you not give yourself the honor to view before his grace?
Oh, my love, it is so small a matter. Still, you may well do it.
The young man seems to entertain but an imperfect appreciation of the respect due from a meal to a Castilian Hidalgo.
My child, his feelings.
Sir, come, I have no patience with the presumption of persons in his plebeian position. If he does not appreciate that position, let it be whipped until he does.
Well, let us hope that this omission was not intended as a slight. I would be very much hurt than I thought it was, and so would he. No matter. Where are the halberdiers who were to have met us here, that our visit to the Grand Inquisitor might be made in becoming state?
Your Grace, the halberdiers are mercenary people who stipulated for a trifle like that.
How tiresome. Well, let us hope that the Grand Inquisitor is a blind gentleman. And the band. The band who was had the honor and assault us. I see no band.
Your Grace, the band are assorted persons who require to be paid in advance.
That's so like a band.
Became a Wesleyan Methodist. bad terrier caused your smiling and unconscious husband to be stolen and conveyed to Venice. A fortnight hence, that Methodist monarch and his Wesleyan pot were killed in action! Which brings us here to Venice, where we hope to ascertain the location of your husband and to hail you, our daughter, the reigning queen of Bertaria.
Your Majesty.
It is at points such as these that one does feel the necessity to travel with a full band.
nothing, I trust, that will ever give you reason to repent.
May, Lewis, it may not be. I have embraced you for the last time.
Casilda.
I have just learned to my surprise and indignation that I was wed in babyhood to the infant son of the King of Barataria.
The son of the King of Barataria? The child who was stolen in infancy by the Inquisition?
That's the very same. But, of course, you know his story.
Know his story? Why, I have often told you that my mother was the nurse into whose charge he was entrusted.
True, I am. Well, he has been discovered, and my father has brought me here to claim his hand.
But you will not recognize this marriage. It took place when you were too young to understand its import.
May, Lewis, respect my principles and cease indulging me with vain entreaties. Henceforth, my life is another's.
But say, the present and the future, they are another's. But the past, that belongs to us, and none can take it from us. Since we can revel in naught else, let us revel in that.
I don't think I grasp your meaning.
Yet it is logical enough. You say you cease to love me.
I say I may love you.
But you do not say you did not love me.
I loved you with a frenzy that words are powerless to express, and that's but 10 brief minutes since.
Exactly. My own, until 10 minutes since my own. My lately loved, my recently adored. Say that until a quarter of an hour ago, I was all in all to thee.
I see your idea is ingenious, but don't do that.
There can be no harm in reveling in the past.
None whatever, but an embrace cannot be taken to act retrospectively.
Perhaps not.
We may recollect embraces, I recollect many, but we must not repeat them.
Then let us recollect a few. Oh, Priscilla, you were to me as the sun is to the earth.
A quarter of an hour ago.
About that.
Oh, but to think that, but for this miserable discovery, you were to have been my own for life.
Through life and death, a quarter of an hour ago.
Oh, how greedily my thirsty ears would have drunk the golden melody of those sweet words! A quarter, well, it's now only about 20 minutes.
About that, in matters such as these, one cannot be too precise.
And now our love,
could have hoped Her Majesty's excess of dignity had turned us into this style.
Unfortunately, there appears to be some little doubt as to His Majesty's whereabouts.
A doubt as to his whereabouts? Then we may yet be saved.
A doubt? Oh dear, no, no doubt at all. He is here in Venice, flying a modest and picturesque calling of Gondolier. I see him every day. I think of his address. No, in the entire annals of our history, there has been absolutely no circumstance that entirely free from all manner of doubt of any kind whatever. Listen, and I'll tell you all about it. I stole the prince and I brought him here and I left him gaily prattling with a highly respectable gondolier who promised the royal babe to rear and teach him the trade of a tie and near his own beloved Bradley. Both the babes were strong and stout, considering all things clever. Of that there is no matter of doubt, no probable possible sham of doubt, no possible doubt whatever.
No possible doubt whatever.
But knowing I'm much disposed to fear to his terrible taste for tippling, that highly respectable gondolier could never declare with a mind sincere which of the two was his offspring dear and which the royal stripling. Which was which he could never make out despite his best endeavour. Of that there is no matter of doubt, no probable possible shadow of doubt, no possible doubt whatever.
No possible doubt whatever.
I'm sped, and when at the end of a year I sought that infant cherished, that highly respectable gondolier was lying a corpse on his humble bier. I dropped a grand inquisitor's tear, that gondolier had perished. I chased for drink the mind of gout and doubled him up forever. Of that there is no matter of that, no probable possible sham of doubt, no possible doubt whatever. The children followed his old career, that statement can't be parried. Of a highly respectable gondolier, well, one of the two who will soon be here, but which of the two it is not quite clear is the royal prince you married. Search in and out and round about, and you'll discover never a tale so free from every doubt, no probable possible shadow of doubt, no possible doubt whatever.
Closely complicated tangle. But which is it?
what does it matter? If you're both covenants, no kings in detestation, will abdicate once. Good morning.
Oh, don't do that!
Perhaps that's it. There are kings and
kings.
Can I say I test kings? I mean, I test bad kings.
I see.
Ascertain which is the king and which the other. Shropshire Crown.